Hello and welcome to this channel. In this video, we will talk about amyloidosis, its types, diagnosis, and treatment. Amyloidosis is a group of heterogeneous disorders characterized by extracellular deposition of insoluble fibrillar protein called amyloid, which is resistant to degradation. This deposition of abnormal protein leads to the structural and functional dysfunction of the involved organ. Amyloidosis may be hereditary or acquired, or it may be localized or systemic. There are two types of amyloidosis according to the distribution: amyloid deposition in brain in Alzheimer's disease, or amyloidosis of joint, especially shoulder joint, or development of carpal tunnel syndrome in patients who are on hemodialysis. Second type is generalized or systemic amyloidosis. Other classification of amyloidosis is primary amyloidosis or AL type, secondary amyloidosis or AA type amyloidosis, hereditary amyloidosis, hemodialysis related amyloidosis, and senile amyloidosis. First, let us discuss primary amyloidosis or AL amyloidosis. In this amyloidosis, the fibril protein precursor is light chains of monoclonal immunoglobulins, and all those conditions in which there is increased production of light chains like monoclonal gammopathies, including myeloma, Waldenstrom, macroglobulinemia, and other plasmacytomas, all these conditions can lead to AL amyloidosis. The light chains in this amyloidosis include kappa and lambda, especially lambda chains. And the symptoms depends on the organ that is involved. If heart is involved, infiltrative cardiomyopathy or cardiac failure and echocardiography show a speculated pattern. Renal involvement lead to proteinuria or nephrotic syndrome. Nervous system involvement include carpal tunnel syndrome, peripheral and autonomic neuropathy. Gastrointestinal involvement can lead to malabsorption, weight loss, GI hemorrhage, perforation, obstruction, hepatomegaly, and large tongue, which is also known as macroglossia. Macroglossia is not very common, but if it is present, it is usually pathognomonic. And vessel involvement lead to spontaneous purpura, and one of the typical sites is periorbital purpura. Treatment of AL type of amyloidosis is chemotherapy, as that in myeloma, and autologous stem cell transplant. Secondary amyloidosis or AA type. The fibril protein precursor is usually derived from protein A, which is an acute phase reactant, and this leads to the production of serum amyloid A, which deposits in different tissues. So this type of amyloidosis usually results from chronic infections or inflammation. For example, tuberculosis, bronchiectasis, chronic inflammatory diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, ulcerative colitis, Crohn's disease, and osteomyelitis. AA amyloidosis usually affects kidneys, liver, and spleen, and presents with proteinuria, nephrotic syndrome, and hepatosplenomegaly. Macroglossia is not seen, and cardiac involvement in this type of amyloidosis is usually rare. This type of amyloidosis is usually treated by treatment of the underlying condition. Coming on to familial or hereditary amyloidosis, ATTR, this is autosomal dominant condition. Transthyretin is a plasma carrier protein produced by the liver, and in this type of amyloidosis, there is production of abnormal transthyretin due to mutations. And it presents with peripheral or autonomic neuropathy, cardiomyopathy, and renal involvement is unusual. Liver transplant can be curative for this condition. Now, dialysis associated amyloidosis. As the name indicates, this type of amyloidosis develops in chronic renal failure patients who are on hemodialysis. And this develops because of accumulation of circulating beta 2 macroglobulin, which is poorly filtered by dialysis membrane. Manifestation occurs in 5 to 10 years after the start of dialysis, and clinical features include carpal tunnel syndrome, chronic arthropathy, and pathological fractures secondary to amyloid bone cysts. Senile systemic amyloidosis is a feature of normal aging, and normal transthyretin protein is deposited in the tissues. It usually occurs in people more than 70 years of age and affects more than 90% of people more than 90 years of age. It is usually asymptomatic. Diagnosis of amyloidosis is usually done by biopsy and Concorde staining. Abdominal fat and rectal biopsy are most commonly used because these are non-invasive sites and the yield is almost 80%. Or if the abdominal fat or rectal biopsy is non-yielding, then biopsy of the involved organ is usually contemplated. These amyloid deposits stain red with Congo stain and show apple green fluorescence in polarized light. Immunohistochemical staining is used to identify type of amyloid fibrin. These days, quantitative scintigraphy using indium-labeled serum amyloid P is increasingly being used and is a valuable tool in determining the overall load and distribution of amyloid deposits. I hope you liked this video. If so, please share with your colleagues and subscribe to this channel.